Time to take the makeup off. I mean, a lot of people talk about taking off makeup as though it's a mask, and just everyone, and this is not scripted or thought out whatsoever, I'm just taking makeup off and filming it as an excuse to make another video. But anyway, and also I can't see right now because the glasses. But a lot of people say take off your makeup as though it's a mask that needs to be removed. And it's strange because I don't think makeup's really a mask. It's just something a lot of people use to make them feel better about themselves or just feel more confident or enhance features that they already think look poppin'. I mean, a lot of makeup artists, well, most makeup artists, most people are absolutely stunning without makeup. They use makeup to make them look better in one way or another, and that's okay. So, personally, I think we should stop putting people down for the amount of makeup they wear or don't wear. I mean, it's their life. It's none of your business, none of my business. People wanna three layers of foundation? Great. People wanna wear six layers of foundation? Great. People wanna wear no layers of foundation? Also, completely great. I mean, since I've not been at school, and even when I was at school for the last part of it during exam season, I hardly wore makeup. I was like, you know what? Don't have time for this. Don't have effort. Don't have, like, the energy to keep up with it. Because, I mean, it takes a long time. It takes me like a good 40 minutes to do my makeup because I'm slow and I get distracted and I like things to look okay enough to go out, etc. Like, I remember when I needed to get my eyeliner, like this was back in like 2015, 2014 time, when my eyeliner needed to be even, like, even, like kind of sisters, twins, joined at the hip kind of even. And I used to literally spend hours on that. I got up at like 6 every morning when I live like 2 minutes away from my school, literally. Takes me one song to get to school. Well, I mean, it did. Now I don't go to that school anymore. And I put so much effort into making myself look good because I thought everyone else cared. I thought that because I started wearing makeup, like a lot of it, like major 7. So I mean, thought everyone expected it and would like look at me weirdly if I didn't wear makeup. And be like, oh god, she's ugly without that. And then one day, I had my French speaking exam. I want to say, No, it would have been my second French speaking. And I was bricking it. Like, I was terrified. So I went in with no makeup on because I was like, you know what? I'm going to cry anyway. I was crying off. And I went in. It was the first time I hadn't worn foundation to school for 4 years. No one cared. No one. I got a joke off like 2 friends saying, oh, you look red today. And I'm like, yeah, I know. I've been crying. Like, oh, alright. And then for the most part of year 11, I was just like, you know what? I don't have time for this. I can get up an hour later. Still be on school on time. And still, no one cares. And I'm not wasting product on people that don't care about how popular I look, because frankly, I want compliments. God, that sounded so conceited. Wow. Oh well. Here's what it is. So. Anyway. Now it's time to use the micellar water. I haven't used since I got off holiday, because I haven't worn makeup in a good 2 weeks. And I remember, like, before my mum bought me this, I thought that makeup removal wipes, they would so much and got everything off. Turns out they don't. They don't get any of it off. They get like top layer. Nah, there's still loads of it. And then I wonder why I have bad skin. I'm like, oh, whoa, why do I have bad skin? Feel sorry for me. Me doesn't take care of my skin. Ugh. Oh. Like, I use. It's all water in my eye. Ow, that hurts. In my oh, that was a bad pun. I use Simples and I'm pretty sure it's cruelty free, but I need to double check because my mum bought it and I mean, like, I'm not going to say no because that's mean. But yeah, I do need to check if Simple cruelty free or not. But yeah, if it is cruelty free, go buy it. I'll leave it in the description whether it is or not because I'm not sure. But and if it's not and you don't really care about being cruelty free, go buy it. It's really decent and gets all of the gunk out of your face, makeup wise. It's good. Nice. I usually use like 3 cotton pads, like little ones, because they're good. So anyway, I haven't really done much of a chat, I've just talked at you. Well, I mean, you're on camera, so I mean, what else am I meant to do? Anyway, to anyone who's watching, how's your day been? How's your week been? How's your life going? Are you feeling alright? I'm gonna have to come closer because I feel like I haven't gotten any of this out. But how's your life going? Are you doing alright? Hope you are, because I mean, it's always nice when people are doing good. Well, even can't be doing good, you can do something. No, it has to be well. I need to stop having grammar conversations with myself. They're really quite sad, but yeah, I think I'm getting most of it off now. So anyway, when people say take off your makeup, it's kind of like they're referring to a mask that you hide yourself in, and I guess to some extent, I can't even see that without my glasses, that's how bad my sight is. I can see now, wow. But I think when people refer to taking off your makeup, it's more like taking off a mask, and don't necessarily agree with that, because I think everyone has their masks in one way or another. It might be makeup, it might be the shoes you wear, it might be sarcasm or jokes or being quiet, it could be anything. And I think asking someone to take off a mask that probably makes them feel comfortable is a bit mean. So, yeah. Don't know. Moral, don't ask people to take off masks. Don't know what I'm saying, so I'm gonna shut up and go to bed now. Yeah. See you tomorrow. Bye.